Gentlemen, men of science and nonsense, I've called together this urgent meeting of our scientists because we know that Charlie Chaplin is planning to build a bomb that's going to blow up the whole world. What? That's not Charlie Chaplin? Who's he? Groucho Marx is planning to build a bomb to blow up the entire world because all his movies bombed at the box office. What? Oh, sorry, that's Adolf Hitler. Hitler is planning to blow up the whole world. Gentlemen, Hitler's planning to blow up the whole world. And you men of science have been called here today to build a bigger bomb than the one he's building so that we can blow up the world faster than he can, right? That would be a good idea, right? So get to work, men of science. Your bystanding days are over. Your bystanding days are over. Now it's time for your by-sitting days. Before I say goodbye to all of you, in case you don't succeed in making the bomb. And I say goodbye to all of you, even if you do succeed in making the bomb, because after the bomb explodes, it'll be a goodbye to all of us, right? Gentlemen, I am Professor Dumpstein from the Dumpstein Institute of Elementary Physics and Ordinary Shit. Gentlemen, I say let Hitler blow up the world. Because if he blows up the world, he'll blow up with it, and that'll be the end of Hitler. I bet nobody ever thought of this. What? Except for the fact that we are also upon the planet Earth, right? That means if the world blows up, Hitler blow up, and we'll blow up with him. And who wants to blow up with him anyway, right? That is a complex city. Okay, I just have one word to add. That the team of scientists in Hitler's cabinet who are working on the building of the bomb is led by Dr. Otto Hahn, ladies and gentlemen, and he's working on it pretty fast. And just by the way, I might as well tell you that I happen to be Professor Otto Hahn as well. I'm working as a dual identity, you know, a double agent. So if you pay me more than Hitler's paying me, I might build the bomb for you here, right? Traitors galore. History is built up not upon heroic men, but upon the exploits of traitors like us, right? So now I hand over the microphone to Professor Beanstein while I get the hell out of here. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Professor Beanstein. I work as a clerk in the patent office, really, and I invented the theory of bi-relativity. And that theory of mine is so potent and so powerful that if Hitler blows up the world once, we shall make a bomb to blow up the world twice. But first, let him give us the demonstration. Let him blow up the world at least once, and then we'll show him how to blow it up twice, okay? Now, I've got a lot of equations sticking around, right? And one of those equations is bound to work, right? But I haven't worked on all of them because the equation that works might be the fatal equation, right? And I wouldn't want to blow up myself while working on the equation, right? So I'll hand over the equation to juniors here, right? And when they start working on it, the juniors can blow themselves up, right? That's what juniors are meant for, to blow themselves up, while us seniors get the hell out of here. So, my theory is the theory of relativity. C is the velocity of light, right? M is equal to m0 divided by the square root of 1 minus v squared by c squared, right? where c is again the velocity of light. What else could it be, right? Under these circumstances, everything here is the velocity of light, and that's the speed with which we have got to get out of here before Hitler finds out we are plotting against him. T is equal to T0 divided by the square root of 1 minus v squared upon c squared. All these equations. One tells us the time dilates. This means if you go fast enough, you'll come back as your own grandfather, because time will have dilated and stopped. If you go too fast, you become fat. You'll put on weight. So the thin people can go at the speed of light and become massive supernovas. And then last, there was a lady named Miss Bright who could travel faster than light. She departed one day in an Einsteinian way, and she came back the previous night. There was a young man named Fisk whose fencing was very brisk. So fast was his action that the Fitzgerald contraction reduced his sword to a disc. So when I mix up all these three equations in a little hat, I mix them together here. Then I take my magic wand, right? Then I take my magic wand. First of all, let me mix them up. Gentlemen, I wish to give you a live demonstration of these three equations. I'm going to mix them up into this melting pot. And then we see what happens. When I mix up the melting pot into the pot that melts, then what happens? I come out with the final, fatal equation. E is equal to, and I forgot the rest. Alzheimer's disease struck me at the wrong moment. Does anyone remember what E equals? Even a high school kid is supposed to know that these days. What's wrong with you people? E is equal to mc squared, right? And that equation, ladies and gentlemen, is going to blow up the whole world, including all of us. So what are we complaining about, right? We got nothing to worry about. Right? And gentlemen, with E is equal to mc squared, one day a bomb is going to be built. And when I say one day, I mean tomorrow. And then it's going to be lifted up in an aeroplane by a pilot who'll go singing, "So long, Mom, I'm off to drop the bomb, so don't wait up for me. So long, Mom, I'm off to drop the bomb, so don't wait up for me. So, but while you swelter down in your shelter, you can see me on your TV. While we are attacking frontally, watch Brinkley and Huntley describing counterpointly the cities we have lost. No need for you to miss a moment of the agonizing Holocaust." Pilot, and no shrinking violet was he. He was mighty proud when World War III began. He wasn't scared, no siree. And this is what he sang on his way to Armageddon. "So long, Mom, I'm off to drop the bomb, so don't wait up for me. But while you swelter down in your shelter, you can see me on your TV." Okay, boys, there it is. The ice cream of E is equal to mc squared shall be served after the meeting. How's that? Once when we have blown up the whole world, there's no need to be afraid of Hitler, because Hitler will be a part of the world, and so will we. That's the glitcher. But who cares about glitches at a time like this, when it's time to make switches? So make the switch of the nuclear bomb. And when I say fire, don't fire, right? Let's get out of the world first. How do you get out of the world? Does anyone know how to get out of the world? Well, then we are stuck here, I believe. And we are stuck here, and we might as well not fire the bomb, right? How's that? The reason we are stuck here is because somebody put chewing gum on our seats and our pants are stuck to the chairs beneath. So we are stuck here right now. Can't leave this conference as fast as we thought we could. Can we? Gentlemen, there is some good news from Hitler. He has decided to postpone the making of the bomb until he has seen how well our bomb works, right? So let's show him how well our bomb works. Who cares for his bomb, right? Okay, boys, E is equal to MC squared. And what happens then? See what I mean?